The number one weed that our team works on at the University of Tennessee is annual bluegrass. In this video, we'll review options for annual bluegrass control during Bermudagrass dormancy. So in any research trial, it's important to have non-treated control plots or non-treated check plots, and that's what you see here. We have replicated all of our treatments in this test, and we have non-treated check plots in every replication that allow us to evaluate the performance of our experimental treatments compared to if we had done nothing. And if we look at our non-treated, we have our 5x5 square here, and inside the center of that square, we have the white lines on the periphery. We can see a healthy infestation of Poa annua, as well as an array of winter annual broadleaf weeds. And what we're going to look at over the next few plots here are applications made kind of in the heart of winter dormancy. That's a time where many turfgrass managers, be it late December or into January and February, if they get a warm day where we have air temperatures over, say, 50 Fahrenheit, like to go out and try to clean up dormant Bermudagrass. And that's what we're going to look at over the next few plots are dormant options for Poa annua control in hybrid Bermudagrass. So this is an important plot to look at. Often through extension, we get questions about what does resistance look like. This is what resistance looks like. So the population of Poa annua at this site is resistant to glyphosate, and we can see that here. So this is an application of glyphosate, Roundup Pro at 32 fluid ounces per acre, mixed with Ronstar Flow at 121 fluid ounces per acre. This is very common on golf courses across Tennessee to make this application during dormancy. It allows broad spectrum control from the Roundup of winter annual weeds post-emergence, and then it positions Ronstar Flow before the germination and subsequent emergence of summer annual weeds. We see here very, very limited activity from the Roundup in that mixture on Poa annua. We have a little bit of yellowing, but those plants by and large will survive. You'll notice in the center of the plot there are a handful of plants that are a little more effective, and they're almost more orange or yellow in color than the rest. And that polka dot type appearance is what we see when we have populations segregating for resistance, and it's a real indicator to the turfgrass manager that a new control measure is needed if you see that at your site. So this treatment is a little bit early when we think about a dormant window. This was applied on December 9th. This is Cheetah Pro, which is a newer herbicide from New Farm that contains glufosinate. And this was mixed with SureGuard, another New Farm herbicide, at 12 fluid ounces per acre. And SureGuard is labeled for annual bluegrass control in dormant Bermudagrass. And again, we can see here this application made on December 9th, when we're looking at this now in the spring of 2021, has done a really good job of controlling Poa annua in this stand to tiff way, maintained at fairway height. So here we have another mixture. Again, this was applied on December 9th. This is Negate mixed with Barricade and Princept. The rationale behind this treatment was, what would happen if we missed our optimal window for a zone defense mixture? We've talked in other videos about that. For Tennessee, at least, that optimal window is late October, maybe into early November. What would happen if weather conditions wouldn't allow for that application to be made? Could we still get the efficacy that we would like? And we can see here, at least with this one combination of Negate, Barricade, and Princip at this site, it's done fairly well from an annual bluegrass control standpoint. So this is a little bit more typical of a dormant application timing. What you see here is an application of Cheetah Pro applied on February 2nd. Cheetah Pro is a newer herbicide from New Farm that contains glufosinate, a non-selective herbicide used for Poa annua control in dormant Bermudagrass. Application rate here is 82 fluid ounces per acre. one of the common questions that turfgrass managers have about glufosinate products is in regards to the rate discrepancy. Finale, which was the only glufosinate product for a long time, is less concentrated than Cheetah Pro, so the broadcast application rate is much higher. Here, with this 82 fluid ounce per acre rate applied on February 2nd, we can see our annual bluegrass control here is excellent. And it's important to note that we have no surfactants. In subsequent treatments, we're going to talk about Cheetah Pro with different surfactant packages, because that can be important when making applications in this dormant window of early spring, particularly with herbicides that are not readily translocated. So here we have Cheetah Pro, 82 fluid ounces, and this was mixed with ammonium sulfate. As mentioned earlier, one of the things with Cheetah Pro is that it is not readily translocated, so we want to make sure that we can get optimal absorption and entry into the plant to get the control that we would like from an application to our turf. So here we've included ammonium sulfate to do that, and we can see our results here are excellent. So here we have a mixture. This is Cheetah Pro mixed with SureGuard, and we have the same ammonium sulfate in there as well as NIS. And this is really important because we know that we have glyphosate resistance issues across Tennessee, particularly on golf courses within Poa Annua, and that is not unique to Poa Annua and turf. That is a major resistance issue in all of agriculture. And recently we have first reports of glufosinate resistance in row crop systems. So we want to do everything we can in a turf context to prevent that from happening. And that's what we're doing here in mixing our Cheetah Pro with SureGuard, a different mode of action from glufosinate. So here we have an application of Finale at 192 fluid ounces per acre. If that rate sounds high, that has to do with the concentration of glufosinate in the older formulation of Finale that's been in the industry for some time now. This was applied on February 2nd, and we can see our results in controlling Poa Annua here in this dormant stand of Tifway are excellent. So here we have Finale XL. This is a new formulation of Finale being developed by BASF that has a higher concentration of glufosinate, which allows us to have a lower application rate. You'll see in this plot the rate is 82 fluid ounces. In the older formulation of Finale, the rate was 192 fluid ounces. So we have concentrated our glufosinate more, allowing us to have a lower application rate from a broadcast spectrum, and really no differences in efficacy when we compare Finale XL to our older formulation of Finale. So this is a mixture of Reward and Princep, two modes of action. Reward here at 2 pints per acre, Princep at 2 quarts per acre. This has been a treatment that golf course superintendents who have struggled with glyphosate resistance issues, several have moved into this treatment for control. For whatever reason in this test, we are not seeing the performance out of Reward Simazine that we have in previous tests evaluating that combination. Reasons for that are unclear, but knowing that it's two different modes of action, it has definitely a fit as a tool to help with glyphosate resistance management. So here we have a mixture of Katana and Sencor. The idea behind this mixture is that Sencor applications to green Bermudagrass can cause some temporary injury. If we put this out in a dormancy window, maybe we could have some Poa Annua control and also have mode of action diversity to help Katana, an ALS inhibitor. So these two herbicides were put together and applied on February 2nd. We can see the results here. We've certainly reduced our population compared to a non-treated control. Still some plants remaining though, and it remains to be seen. ALS inhibitors particularly are slow in colder weather. It'll be interesting to watch this plot as we go out through spring and temperatures become warmer to see if maybe the control will accelerate. So this is an important plot to take a moment and look at. So this is curb applied at 3.5 pints per acre, and the application was made February 2nd. And it's important because often turfgrass managers rely on curb for post-emergence Poa Annua control, and we know that that becomes a taller order, a harder thing to achieve once plants become really mature. The bigger the plants are, the more mature, it's going to take a longer time for curb to deliver the results that we want. And if you look at a curb label, you'll see that rates increase as plant size increases as well. We know through research, and you've seen in other videos, that the optimal curb timing for Tennessee is late October into early November. And a lot of that is predicated upon Poa Annua at that time is newly emerged. It is in a kind of juvenile stage. It's easy to be controlled in that juvenile stage, and because a sizable percentage of our yearly cumulative emergence has happened, we don't have a lot left to go, so it's less of an ask on the residual component of curb. Here, applying in February, we've got really mature plants, as we can see in the photo, and our weather conditions are really cold, right? And that's not going to be an optimal environment for curb to deliver what we want either. So we've really poorly positioned our curb application with this treatment, and using that as a teachable moment where we'd like to see turfgrass managers in Tennessee, if curb's going to be one of the tools that they want to employ for Poa control, to position that more towards mid-fall. So as you can see, there are many options for controlling Poa Annua in dormant hybrid Bermudagrass at fairway height. One of the things that we know is that resistance to glyphosate is fairly widespread within Poa Annua. So one of the recommendations from UT Extension is to diversify what you're doing. If you've been using glyphosate for many years without rotation to anything different during that dormant window, certainly time to consider a glufosinate product, and potentially a glufosinate product in mixture with another mode of action. And hopefully you can take some of the treatments from this test and implement them when it's time for dormant applications in the winter of 2021 and in early spring of 2022. I'd like to take a moment to thank multiple groups that have supported the research that you've seen in this video and other videos on Poa Annua control from the University of Tennessee. With all of our trial work, everything you've seen in this video has been replicated at other locations across the state. And I'd like to thank all of the superintendents within the Tennessee Golf Course Superintendents Association that have supported that work and been host sites for trials. We really couldn't do it without you, and having multiple locations really gives us more confidence and more power to the results. So thank you to those that have helped with auxiliary sites. I'd like to thank the East Tennessee Research and Education Center, kind of the home to UT Turfgrass Research, for providing us a facility and opportunity to do the bulk of our work that we do in the Turfgrass Weed Science program. I'd also like to thank the Tennessee Turfgrass Association, as well as the Tennessee Valley Sports Turf Managers Association, for their support, not only of this research, but all the research we do within the UT Turfgrass program. And then lastly, I'd like to thank numerous industry supporters, particularly those that have submitted treatments for inclusion in these programs. Having your support to do this work and provide turfgrass managers solutions to this problem of Poa Annua control in turf is much appreciated. So thank you for that.